This is a great illustration of that spectrum where you have the range of potential diagnoses that might present. And, you know, you have your categorical classifications, which are useful for clinical practice or benchmarks for us. But most people, frankly, humans, fall along a continuum. And we have to appreciate that that continuum is what we really need to lean into in terms of understanding that presentation. Unfortunately, most of my patients don't come in with a clear checklist. So a checklist really isn't enough anymore to be able to make a valid diagnosis. And to your point, mixed data on early age of onset in bipolar 1 versus bipolar 2, and the fact that depression may precede precursor to mania, but then also may present later in life, helps us understand that these things are not just dimensional, but they're also dynamic over the course of time.
You know, when I sit with a patient, I've done this for so long now, and I've often been thinking to myself, is the lesion bipolarity or is the lesion cyclicity?
Yeah, good one.
In other words, is the defining feature of bipolarity the person is hypomanic or manic? Well, according to DSM, that is in fact the defining feature. But if you listen to the patient's story and you listen to how they describe what's happening, they're describing more cyclicity. In other words, what they're saying is that early in life, in their teenage years, they became more moody. And they started knowing that their sleep wasn't quite right. Then they started having anxiety. Then they started getting involved with some cannabis. Then the depression came on board, and their mood is never really steady. Not that they're going high or going low, but they're cycling. And the cycling is often affected by different environmental factors like sleep and the seasons and so on. Women of reproductive age, usually some of these aspects around menses or pregnancy and so on. And so the debate continues, but it's interesting because I'm often listening to cyclicity when I'm talking to patients, not only for bipolarity. Said differently, a patient comes to my office age 32 and they've had 3, 4, 5, 6 depressions. I start wondering, is this cyclicity more bipolar than it is unipolar? And not uncommonly, I'll prescribe lithium for highly recurrent unipolar patients.